is almost Labor Day weekend. We are live with the owner of Huntington Meats with the top five cuts of meat for Labor Day grilling.
Meat, Mark, because Labor Day is coming. That means barbecue. A lot of people are going to be barbecuing, and we've got some great guests here. John and Jim, they're from Huntington Meats, and it's the go-to place for getting really high-quality meat for the barbecue grill. This weekend, it's very, very important. First of all, tell me where your place is located.
Third and Fairfax. We're in the original Farmers Market, 633 West 3rd Street. It's been there since 85 years now.
And you're into aging meat. What is that all? How long does it age, and what is the process?
30 to 40 days. We use a salt method to drain the moisture out of the meat. We have all variations of meat that we do dry age.
All right, let's go through and see what we got here, because we got the five best cuts of meat.
Definitely.
For the barbecue grill, because there's some is not so good. Some is good and some is not so good, right?
Right.
There's definitely changes in quality. All right, let's start off with what we got here. This is the before and the after, what we're
doing. Right. This is the porterhouse. It's the New York portion with the filet separated by the bone. It's prime. I only carry prime beef, even in our dry age.
Not a lot of fat on that. Just, it looks really lean.
Yeah.
So on the cook product, we want to do a 2-minute sear aside.
Uh-huh.
And then from there, we want to indirect heat for 4 to 6 minutes for a nice medium rare.
Indirect heat means you put it, you turn off the grill on that part, and then
yes, you can turn it off the middle. You can turn it off, or you can move to the top of the shelf.
All right.
If you have a shelf.
Moving on down the line here. That is a large cut.
Yes.
What is that?
This is the tomahawk.
How many pounds is that thing?
It's about 3.
Uh-huh.
About 3 pounds. It's prime as well. It's a 14-inch bone. It's the extended rib. And it's a delicious cut if you like ribeyes, because basically that's what it is.
All right. And what do we got over here? This looks like a tri-tip to me. Could I be wrong? Is that a tri-tip?
No, this is a marinated tri-tip in our barbecue sauce that we have, a spicy barbecue. I recommend when you're marinating, at least do it for 24 hours. More it soaks in, marinates, you'll get a better result.
And for cooking tips on tri-tips, you want to do like a 4 to 5 minute sear on each side.
Right.
Then we want to go to indirect heat for 20 to 25 minutes. Let rest for 5 minutes. That'll bring it down to a nice medium rare. Slice thin, serve.
All right, I want to talk to you about this. I mean, I was always taught that if you press in your hand right here, that's what you want in terms of meat, to know that it's done on the barbecue. Is that true?
Exactly. You can go and just kind of feel it. If it's too spongy, you want to go a little longer. That's going to be a rare.
Right.
So once it starts tightening up.
And you do not cut the meat when it comes right off the barbecue.
You don't
cut it. What do you do?
Let it rest. That's the key to everything.
Right.
Letting it rest.
Let it rest for how long?
Depends on what the product is. This here, about 4 to 5 minutes. Something like this, about 8 minutes.
Okay, and then you can cut it safely.
Then you cut cross grain, and you're serving.
All right, you got one more cut of beef here to show us.
This is the agahashi beef.
Agahashi.
Is that the right?
Akaushi.
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 All right, tell me what this is all about. Why is this special?
It means red, the name. Uh-huh. They get a red Wagyu beef, and they breed it with the red Angus. It's done in Texas. This will knock your socks off.
This I'll bet it's expensive, too.
Well, it is, but if you want good quality and stuff, you come to me.
All right.
but this is really, really will knock your socks off.
And it
off
melts in your mouth, I'll bet, when you get
flavor and taste, exactly. You got it.
All right.
Exactly. Cooking on here, because it's so rich with the trans fats that carry a lot of omega-3s, all you got to do is salt and pepper this, grill it to order. Something like this, like a 2-minute side, let it rest, slice it down, ready to serve.
Awesome. All right. We also have sausages here, and we're running out of time, but you can do this stuff as well. You don't have to buy steaks, you can buy sausages.
Right. We make all of our sausage, including these. We're known for 20 sausages being shown every single day.
Right. Awesome.
If you need sausage, if your grandfather had a recipe, come and see us. We'll try to duplicate it.
Meanwhile, look at Krisky. He's right over here, and he's got a plate in his hand. Look at him.
Ready.
He is ready. All right, let's give the information on Huntington Meats and sausages. They're located at the original Farmers Market. stall number 350 on West 3rd Street in Fairfax in Los Angeles. They're open on Labor Day, and for more information, you can check out their website. Thank you so much for coming in. The newsroom's going to, you leave this for us, I hope.
Yeah, we're going to cook it off a little bit more.
We're going to start slicing and eating real soon.
There we go. Definitely.
All right, thanks so much. Jessica, we'll send it back to you.
Oh, it all looks good, guys. Thanks so much.